I think there's way too much in terms of from a process point of view that's gone wrong within how we have approached the tech layoffs. I think there is a reality, you know, in terms of the digital boom being over, companies have to right size. They're also looking at inflation, a possible recession. So there will be difficult conversations that we do need to have. What I worry about is that we've been very inhumane in some of our approaches in terms of how companies have approached this. And I think there's a different way that you can look at this.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to HR Hot Topics, which is the show in which we talk about some of the stories that we've read in the news in the past month and analyze how it is impacting the world of work and us as HR professionals. And today's big topic will be around the layoffs that we're seeing in the tech sector and how they're impacting our organizations and us as HR professionals as well, because I think we need to be prepared. I'm Erik van Vulpen, with me is Dieter Veldsman. Let's dive right in. Before we start, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really interested in even more stories, check out our community at AIHR.com. Our main story for today is what the wave of tech layoffs tell us about the economy. It's from CNN Business, and it is analyzing the different layoffs that we've seen at Twitter, Microsoft, Meta, Amazon, and other companies. They are laying employees off at a massive scale. We've all seen Twitter and Elon, who fired essentially half of the population by overwork email, essentially saying, you know, you're from today locked out of your account. And if you get the login, then you can stay at the company. You don't have to come to the office unless you hear that we retain you. That to me feels like the world is upside down, Dieter.
Agree. I think there's way too much in terms of from a process point of view that's gone wrong within how we have approached the tech layoffs. I think there is a reality, you know, in terms of the digital boom being over, companies have to right size. They're also looking at inflation, a possible recession. So there will be difficult conversations that we do need to have. What I worry about is that we've been very inhumane in some of our approaches in terms of how companies have approached this. And I think there's a different way that you can look at this.
So let's look at this topic. First of all, why is it happening? How to go about it if you lay off people? And then third, what HR can do, how we as HR professionals can prepare for this. So the first question is, why is this happening, Dieter?
So I think there's a couple of reasons, Erik, and I just want to raise one or two. I think during the pandemic, we saw a lot of these companies actually increasing hiring to capitalize on the digital opportunities. So you can make the argument that the companies inflated themselves during the COVID pandemic period and now have to right size now that their profit margins are not necessarily, or they're not delivering on the growth that they wanted to see.
Yeah.
So that's definitely one of the reasons.
Mark Zuckerberg actually said that. He said, you know, the surge of e-commerce led to outsized revenue growth, and that's why we now have too many people on the payroll.
I also think we're moving out of that, can I call it Silicon Valley era, where, you know, vaporware was put forward, I got very easy investment, and all of a sudden I can hire a team of, you know, thousands of people. So I think companies, and from an investor point of view, I think they are going to keep a much cleaner eye in terms of who they give money to and when and where and with which kind of strings attached to it as well.
Yeah, we see that across the board, that the cost of capital is increasing tremendously. Capital is literally twice as expensive, if not more expensive. And for companies that first, you know, had this blitz scaling approach where it's growth above everything, these companies are now realizing, like, hang on, if I don't have a profit margin, any additional fundraising that I do is going to be 2 to 4 times more expensive. So we need to get break even and get a profit margin going, because otherwise we have a big problem and I don't own the company anymore after my next fundraising round.
And I think it also points towards the fact that I think we are being held accountable for some of those decisions and the consequences of those that we've made, you know, during the, call it the exciting startup scale up phase in the organization. It's almost like we're growing up and going to school, going to university, and now you have to start taking responsibility for a lot of those things. And I would think sustainability is going to become a really important conversation in the decisions that we make today.
The problem or the sad thing about this is, you know, bad decisions that are made in the past will affect working people working at these organizations. We're seeing layoffs. I think there's also an opportunity in it for many other companies, because we're focusing very much on the tech sector today. So tech employees that are being laid off. At the same time, we do still see a massive shortage of labor in the broader US economy. So some of these tech workers, you know, are very much have transferable skills that many other organizations can still use. So there may also actually be a silver lining to this.
And I think that's where HR can really play a role, Erik, with regards to that. Because something that I do think we just need to be careful of is there's almost this groupthink mentality at the moment where it's all about just the tech sector. And yes, these things are really tough in the tech sector at the moment, but there are other sectors where there is the opportunity for transferable skill. does bring it back to the fact that, do you really understand as an individual what your transferable skill is and how you can go and apply that elsewhere?
Yeah, and I think their HR has a big role to play. So let's move to the second part of this this topic. How to go about it if you do need to implement layoffs in your organization?
I think we've seen a couple of different approaches that tech companies have taken. And, you know, we can argue which one is right and wrong. I think they all have got benefits and some of them have got limitations, bar one. I don't agree with what Twitter did at all. I think it was really inhumane in terms of how they just treated that whole conversation in the uncertainty as well. And I think that spiraled in terms of a lot of other companies making too hasty decisions.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree there. And even the stories of, you know, half the organization being fired and then a day later you get a call, you know, because people were fired incorrectly. And if you could come back to work, you know, we see the retweet button break down the next day. So I think there's a lot of things that we can improve. Looking at it broader, you know, if you're in HR and you know your organization is at risk of being laid off, what are some of the things that you can do to start preparing for this?
I think the obvious one is definitely on the hiring freeze side, you know, in terms of saying, but let's first understand what is it that we need now and what is it that we have at the moment. I've been a firm supporter over the years of a more staggered approach if you do have to go in terms of a right-sizing exercise to say, but over a period of time, is there not opportunity with as talent leaves the organization to reshape what we have? I'm not a big fan of the pull the band-aid off approach. That's just literally, let's send out a mail, it's 12,000 people the next day, you know, hopefully you can log in.
No, absolutely agree there. And that's also what we see, you know, if you're part of a big restructuring, you lose faith in the organization, you know, that psychological contract is broken, you see much higher turnover of anyone who stayed after the layoff, you know, turnover, I think, is in the realms of twice as large as it was before. So I'm curious, Dieter, what can HR do in these situations?
Erik, I think it starts really with helping the organization, and here I'm referring to leaders and managers in the organization, understand what other options are available. If we have to go the route of layoffs, how do we do that in a fair, consistent, and humane way? And research time and time again tells us it's about the communication, it's about the consultation, it's much more about the actual process and how we approach it. And I think their HR can play a very key role, also bearing in mind that in a lot of these companies, HR is also impacted by these layoffs.
I like what you said earlier about transferable skills, because I think a lot of this has to do with skills also as an employee in the organization. When you think more in terms of transferable skills, you know, what are other roles that I could play as an employee as part of my career path, as part of my development, but also, you know, if we do need to restructure that organization, what are the transferable skills that we have in the organization so that we can potentially move people to other posts where they can leverage those same skills. So I think there's also a big angle for HR to focus that, you know, career development and that personal development conversation much more towards skills and the role of skills. And I think their HR can help employees a lot.
Agree. And I think there's, you know, this is such a great opportunity to use this situation to really start thinking about things like internal marketplaces where I can move people around. I think we're also starting to see some companies looking at renegotiating our employee relationships and contracts to say, but how can I actually cater for this in a bit of a different way to best still benefit both parties? The point I also want to make to HR professionals working in that sector at the moment is you are not alone. I think there's a whole HR community that we do need to tap into a lot more that can actually support people broader than just the tech industry when, you know, these types of things happen.
No, definitely. And I think if there's one lesson that we can learn from it is don't be like Twitter. And I think with that, we can start to wrap it up, Dieter.
So I think we also want to talk about, you know, where to from here and what does the future hold, I think, when we start looking beyond just the layoffs that we're currently seeing. We really need to make sure that we are also prepared for what comes after this. And I want to start by really giving a shout out to a LinkedIn post that was posted by Melanie Narango that really spoke about the fact that we also need to honor the HR professionals that is sticking it out in those industries to make sure that fair process and transparent and humane processes are followed. I can imagine that's really, really tough. And I just want to give a shout out to say, let's support each other from a community point of view.
Yeah, and I think it also really speaks about what we call context interpretation for HR professionals. Because, you know, depending on the industry that you're in, you will be positioned in a very different situation. So being aware of what is happening outside of the organization, being aware of macroeconomic influences and how they can potentially affect your organization, this is the time to be really hyper aware of those things. And as an HR professional, build that business acumen and that external organizational understanding, like what is happening specifically in your industry and in your market, to, you know, scenario plan and at least predict the future to some extent.
And I think also to shift the time horizon. And it's been my experience, whenever you're stuck in some of these seasons in an organization with extensive layoffs, etc., very often you become so short-sighted just to get the activities done now that you forget that there's also, you know, there's a workforce that will remain that you need to look after. There's still engagement and productivity types of things that you need to drive during this particular time. I think we're going to see organizations with a lot of survivor's guilt, where a lot of people that remain say, but why am I here, and why is my best colleague that left, why me? And I think HR has to start thinking about that just beyond, you know, this particular season.
And I think finally, it also requires, you know, leaders of these organizations to really step up and be transparent and admit, you know, if you made wrong strategic decisions, admit that and, you know, say that this is the reason why we're, you know, moving towards a layoff. Don't beat around the bush. Don't give other reasons than the actual reasons. Because I think the transparency and the honesty in your communication, especially at these times, is crucial, especially if you still want to have an organization going forward towards the future post-layoff.
And I think we talk about, you know, being the custodian of ethics and HR for good in organizations a lot when we talk about the T-shape. And I think that really this is an opportunity to say, let's make sure that we handle this difficult situation with the right amount of empathy and grace while still being fair around process and being transparent around how we talk about it and communicate and really guide that narrative into the future.
That wraps up our story on the layoffs that we're seeing in the tech landscape and that could hit other industries as well. We've analyzed why is this happening, what is your role as HR if this were to happen in your industry, and what can you do practically in order to soften the blow and to make sure that the organization can still move on post those layoffs.
And Erik, that brings us to the end of this episode of HR Hot Topics. As an HR community, we know it's really tough for some of those professionals working in the tech sector, and we would really like to encourage you, comment below, reach out, let's support each other. Please also reach out if you do know about available opportunities so that we can make sure that people also start to understand what their next step is going to look like. And don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time.